HR teams that we work with to build out project tools often ask for ways to create a list of employees with their basic contact info, their employment status, as well as an easy way to get them onboarded to our organization when hired or offboard from their organization when they leave. This is an example of creating an employee roster, employee onboarding template, and an employee offboarding template. The roster is designed to capture all employees, some key information, and their status within the organization. The employee onboarding and employee offboarding templates are simply sets of tasks to complete when either onboarding or offboarding an employee. So let's jump in, starting with the employee roster. I created this board by clicking on the add on the left-hand side menu, choosing new board, and starting from scratch. Next, I started thinking of the columns that I would like to add to this board. What I had in mind was I wanted to make a form so that the new employee that's being onboarded would be able to fill out the form, which would submit an item to this board in the onboarding section. So I thought about what do I need for this employee to answer on a form that can be mapped to columns. In order to create a form view, we need to create columns first. I added a few different status columns, one for the status of the employee, whether they were onboarding or offboarding. I added a status for hire type, whether they were contract or W-2, and I added a status column for the department of the organization. I also added some other columns such as creation or creation log. You can see this is a creation log column, a last updated column, a text column for position title, a people column for the reporting manager, an email column, phone number column, and a date column for actual start date. To add these columns, just simply click on Add Column. If you don't see what you're looking for here, you can choose more columns. Once I decided on the columns that I needed in the main table, I added a view and I chose Form. Because I had already created the columns, the Form Builder pops up and allows me to create different descriptions, hide, or make different pieces of the form required. You can preview the form by clicking on preview to see what it will look like when the new employee fills it out. We'll walk through this in a little bit. On the right-hand side of the form view, there are also some other settings that you can review and change. When the employee completes this form, it's going to trigger a few awesome automations on the employee roster main table. We'll go over that in the walkthrough a little bit later. After creating the employee roster board and the form view within it, I created the employee onboarding template. Like I said, this is just a list of tasks that need to get done in order to call the employee onboarded. I created this board by clicking on Add, New Board, and starting from scratch. I added different groups so that the different tasks could be grouped together. For example, all of the tasks pertaining to system access are under the group entitled System Access. I added a link column so that the employee would be able to click out to different web addresses. I added a files column so that they could attach maybe a form that they needed to complete as part of a task. I added an email column and renamed it HR email. This way, if there is a form that was uploaded and it needs to be emailed directly to HR, they could click on this button column and an automation will email a link to this file to whatever email it corresponds to. Lastly, when I was finished, I saved it as a template, which you'll notice the wand to the left-hand side. Saving as a template, you just click on the ellipses in the upper right-hand corner of the screen, more actions, and usually right here, it will say convert to template. Because it already is a template, it says remove from templates. So this is what it looks like. Save as template. Next, to create the employee offboarding template, all I did was duplicate this employee onboarding template by clicking the ellipses to the right of employee onboarding template and duplicating the board. I did that because I wanted the group names to remain the exact same. Additionally, I duplicated with the tasks included so that I could simply update what I had already done by saying remove employee email access instead of gaining access, or remove access to Slack, remove access, so on and so forth. So I updated the tasks within this board to cater to offboarding an employee versus onboarding an employee. Lastly, I saved the template. More actions, and that's where usually convert to template is located. After I created all the structures, the employee roster with a form, the onboarding template, and the offboarding template, I went back and added automation so that all of the boards could talk to each other, perform the proper notifications, and take out unnecessary manual work. I started with the employee roster. Within Automate, I created, when status changes to onboarding, create a new board and notify reporting manager. This is located when you click on Add New Automation within Status Change. I created a very similar notification for both onboarding and offboarding. I also created notifications that when status changes to onboarding, move the item to the onboard group. Same with when status changes to offboarding, move item to the offboard group. I came up with a way to auto-assign based on the department that the employee chooses that they're part of. When department changes to marketing, add assignee Kate as the reporting manager. You could replicate this automation for each department and assign different reporting managers. But what triggers all of this is when an item is created, set status to onboarding, meaning when a form is submitted, it's going to create an item on the employee roster main table, which means if it's set to onboarding status, all of these can work based off of this automation that's been created. Within the employee onboarding template, I tried out a beta feature that when a button is clicked, email to HR is the name of the button, clicked, send an email to whatever email is outlined in the HR email column. This is the button column. It's titled email to HR. So theoretically, we can click this and it will actually move this file. When we click this, it will email this file to this recipient here. Looking at the offboarding template, I integrated Slack so that anytime a status had changed to done, we could notify someone directly. I was pretending that KE was the HR manager. So anytime something is completed within this offboarding board per employee, it will notify the HR manager directly. All right, let's walk through it. I am going to fill out this form. Let's choose marketing. I'm going to put their personal email. Phone number. Start date. And we will submit. If we head back to the employee roster main table, it shows that Hannah Smith is under onboard. The status is onboarding. The form was submitted today, March 4th. Last updated was just now. Hiring type is not automatically chosen. That is something that we would want to come in and manually confirm. Marketing specialist was typed in. Marketing department was chosen. So we will notice that the reporting manager via the automation will be auto-assigned. Sometimes it takes a minute for these automations to work. So be patient. Otherwise, you can always hit refresh. When we go back to the employee roster and change Hannah Smith's status to offboarding, this will move Hannah Smith to offboard. And it will also create a Hannah Smith offboarding board here. It shows the integration of Slack right there. We will need to go in, add to board, choose the Slack account, and choose which user to notify. When status is changed to done, we're going to notify Kirsten. Update integration. And that's it. Now you have a robust way of tracking employees onboarding and offboarding. To take it a step further, think of all the other automations you could add templates. Additionally, fill out the templates with any information that you know is static. For example, if you know that someone in particular is always going to provide an employee email address and login information, assign that person within the template so that they're always assigned to get that done. Want to create onboarding template boards per department? No problem. Just duplicate this board, the employee onboarding board, and then tailor it to each different department. For example, operations might have different tasks that need to be completed versus marketing. So on and so forth. If you have any questions about this build, be sure to holler at us in the comments below. If you learned something new, be sure to like the video. Follow us for more Monday.com help. If you're looking to build out Monday.com, but just don't have the time, we totally get it. Get in touch with us on our website, www.pathtosummit.com, and choose a time that works for you to discuss your needs on our calendar. Thanks for watching.